Hello, hi everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another edition of Mail Call. As you can see, I have in front of me five boxes of Malifaux figures. Now, this is apparently a brand new phenomenon that seems to be sweeping the miniature world, and so I thought that you guys might enjoy seeing some reviews of these figures. I'm not going to do the reviews yet. I'm going to wait until next week to get into the reviews and do some open boxing. But what I want you guys to do, I'm going to show you the five boxes that I've got. Now, the Weird Games makes more than five boxes. These are just the five that I chose, all right? If you guys want to see the other box sets, let me know, and I might get them and do some reviews on them. We'll see. But what I want you guys to do is, as I go through these, I'm going to show you what figures are in each box. I want you guys to put some comments in the comment section below as to which set you would like to see reviewed first, okay? And that set will, apparently I'm tired. That set will get reviewed on Tuesday. Now, again, there's five sets. We're going to run basically one review a day, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday of next week. So again, whichever set you would like to see reviewed, just go ahead and put your comments in the comment section below, and we'll do that set first on Tuesday. Okay, so let's get started here. First of all, what is Malifaux? I'm not really sure exactly how to explain it. It's very, think of it as, from what I can tell anyway, just looking at the miniatures, it appears to be some sort of alternate universe, Weird West, Cajun Bayou, Victorian, London, England kind of era. I really don't know how to explain it. The closest thing that I can think of to it is combine, if you will, Terry Pratchett's Discworld with the RPG or collectible card game known as Deadlands/Doomtown, okay? And if you have no idea what I'm talking about, take a look at the figures and you're gonna figure it out. It's going to become very clear when I show you the figures. These are not your normal miniatures, okay? But they are very cool, okay? So, let's rock. The first set that you have an option to pick from is this one here. This is called Perdita. Okay, this is sort of your B-movie 1950s, 1960s Western, all right? What we have here in this box set is a bunch of what look like Mexican banditos, all right? You have Perdita, which is this lady right here. You have Nino, which is dude with the gun, Papa Loco, the guy with the dynamite, Santiago, and Francisco. And again, sort of a Weird West kind of feel to them. You can tell you can tell it's got a Western feel, or a Mexican bandito kind of feel. But you can see, based upon the figures, that it's not the normal universe. Okay, this is definitely something out of the ordinary. All right, and it's kind of hard to describe, but you can see that it's something abnormal. All right, so this set's called Perdita. If you want to see this one, put a comment in the comment section below. Now, next set. This is called Lady Justice. All right. This is another sort of Weird West kind of set. This one, though, instead of being like Mexican banditos, these are samurais in the Old West. All right. So we have this chick here, Lady Justice, with her very long samurai sword. We have this guy over here called the Judge, again, holding what appears to be some sort of medieval weapon, all right, attached to his body with a chain. And then you have these three guys up here at the top called Death Marshals, which are either some sort of undead cowboy, or they are the Western equivalent of a witch hunter. I am not sure which, but I'm sure you could use them as whatever you'd like to. Again, all five pretty darn cool miniatures. But again, this set is called Lady Justice, and if you want to see this on Monday, put a comment in the comment section below. Next, this is the sort of Cajun set called Seamus. Okay, now, Cajun or Louisiana sort of set. All right, on the back, we see the figures. We have Seamus down here, sort of this leprechaun-looking dude. we have these three chicks right here who are sort of zombified Southern belles. They're called Rotten Belles. Okay, they're all wearing the traditional sort of Southern garb from the late 1800s, sort of Civil War era kind of look to them, but they're all very, very zombified. All right, and you can tell they're very, very gross looking. The last one is Madame Cybele, who is this really, really sort of, it almost reminds me of Bull from Night Court, dressed up like the dude from Rocky Horror Picture Show, all right? So, really creepy, creepy set. But again, this set is called Seamus, and if you want to see this reviewed on Tuesday first, then put a comment in the comment section below. Next on the list is the set called Nicodem. I'm assuming it's kind of short for Nicodemus. But this set is another sort of Weird West kind of a set. Here we have Nicodem, who is apparently the Undertaker of the alternate universe. We have this guy over here, Mortimer, who is obviously a grave digger. He's got that cool little shovel there. We have these three guys up at the top called Samurai Punk Zombies. Again, sort of Weird West meets Japan. I'm not really sure exactly how this kind of plays out. Maybe, perhaps, it's kind of like Kung Fu, and these guys are sort of David Carradine. I don't know exactly, but it looks cool. I'll give them that. And the paint jobs on all of these figures in every one of the sets is just incredible. Just beautiful, beautiful miniatures. But again, this set is called Nicodem, and if you want to see this on Tuesday as our first review, put a comment in the comment section below. The last set that we have here is called Sawmerteeth Jones. Now, I'm not exactly sure I'm pronouncing that first name right, but I'm hoping I'm close, okay? This is another sort of Cajun Bayou sort of set, but this set is mostly goblins, all right? This is, or goblin-esque type figures. This is Sawmerteeth Jones right there, obviously the leader of the group. We have over here the War Pig with a goblin rider trying to control it. And then up top here, we have four of what they call Bayou Gremlins, okay? These are obviously just very, very backwoods, goblin-esque sort of figures. Very cute little miniatures. And very neat models. Again, if you want to see this one reviewed on Monday, it's called Sawmerteeth Jones. Put your comment in the comment section below. And we might do that one on, I'm sorry, not Monday, on Tuesday. Okay? So, that's it, guys. You have seen all five of the boxes that I've got. Again, whichever one you want to see reviewed first, put a comment in the comment section below, and we'll review that one first on Tuesday. And then whatever has the next most votes, we'll do that on Wednesday, and then Thursday, Friday, and Saturday until we finish. Okay? But that's it for today, guys. I hope that you have enjoyed this introduction and this mail call as to what I got today. I know it's kind of a lengthy one for only five boxes, but I wanted you guys to see what was on the way and what was coming. But again, I hope you enjoyed it. And that's it for today, guys. If you have any questions or anything, put them in the comment section below. Or send us a PM here on YouTube, and we'll be happy to get back to you. So, God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all next time.